I'm going to go through step by step how to resolve a match problem. Now, what do I mean by a match problem? Well, let's go through and see what Cosmic Slice wrote to us. First off, I'm confused. Well, yes, that is the start of most of our problems. One of my great grand aunts, we'll call her A, has a great granddaughter that I've been in contact with. Great. I love it when people have been in contact with their DNA matches. We'll call this paternal third cousin B. Okay. Now, A has a sister that we'll now call C, who has at least one illegitimate child. All right, so we're dealing now with an NPE in here. We're dealing with a couple of different relationships, and I can see why this is starting to get confusing right away. Maybe you are confused as well. B has what appears to be descended from this child in her ancestry DNA matches, but this person does not appear in either my DNA matches nor my father's. This is the first time she's mentioned her father. I'm not sure how that makes any sense. Well, this is what we like to do, is we like to take problems like this, break them down, and help show you how you can do the same thing with any of the problems that you're confused as well. Now, one of the things I like to do in our live presentations is go to the whiteboard. Let's draw it out. Nice thing about doing this pre-recorded is I can make a little bit better graphics so you don't have to look at all the messiness. But we're going to draw this out, and we're going to draw it out step by step. So let's go back through her statements. First off, one of my great grandaunts, who we're going to label A. All right, so let's draw out this relationship here. You can see that we have Cosmic Slice down here, and I happen to know this is through her father from what she said, but her father, and I don't know these other relationships, but we'll just say through his father, his sister, that would be a great grand aunt. I have Cosmic Slice to tell me that yes, this is right, or no, this is wrong. But based on what she said, a great grand aunt would be in this location right up here. And so I've labeled her A. So this great grand aunt has a great granddaughter B that I've been in contact with. Let's draw that. And it's basically a mirror of what we have over here. So we have Cosmic Slice to her great grand aunt who's got a great granddaughter B. Now, as we're looking at this, we can see that, hey, Cosmic Slice and B happen to be in the same generation. That's just something to put into our head for right now. It's going to be important later. Now, A, that's the great grand aunt, has a sister, C. Okay, so we draw the sister C on here. You'll notice already that this sister C, while Cosmic Slice told us it is the sister of her great grand aunt, well, that sister would also have to be the sister of her great-grandfather. So she could have actually mentioned this relationship in a couple of different ways. These three, by the relationship she said, all have the same parents, which would be the great-great-grandparents of Cosmic Slice. Now, A has a sister C who has at least one illegitimate child, D. Now, this is where it's interesting because we can start to separate out information that we don't need. In this case, Cosmic Slice told me that D is an illegitimate child of C. But because this line of relationship, the great-grandfather of Cosmic Slice, C, who is also a great-grandaunt, and A, who is a great-grandaunt, the spouse or the partner of C doesn't matter. And so this bit of information about D being illegitimate child of C really doesn't matter here. What we know, or what we need to know, is that D is a child of C, because that's how the DNA is going to be shared between all these people that are being labeled. So B has a match M that appears to be descended from D in her ancestry DNA matches. All right, so we're getting into the first match. So D has a descendant who is M. That's our match. And B matches M. But M does not appear in either my DNA matches nor my father's. Okay, so Cosmic Slice over here does not match M, but Cosmic Slice's father also does not match M. So now we have our problem, because she says, I'm confused. How is this possible? Well, let's take stock of what we know. Based on what I've drawn here, all the solid lines, we know those relationships. So we know that Cosmic Slice has her father. We know that she has her great-grandfather, who has two sisters, A and C. So we have those as solid line relationships. Now B, we have solid line relationships back to A because B is A's great-granddaughter. D is the child of C, but what we don't know is what relationship M has to D. We know that M is descended from D, but we don't know how far, how much, whether it's one generation, two generations, three generations, possibly outside chance of four generations. So let's list out the relationships. So S to B, those are third cousins. Okay, this is Cosmic Slice to B. They're third cousins. F to B, this is Cosmic Slice's father to B. They are second cousins once removed. B to M, we don't know because we don't know how M is specifically related to D. So you can see here, this is the third cousins, B and S, which makes this second cousins once removed. But because we don't know on this dotted line how many people there are in between it, we don't know M's exact relationship to these others. So to solve this now, we need to make some assumptions and test those assumptions. So I'm going to assume that there is one generation difference between or M and D. In other words, there's one person in here. I'm going to make that assumption and I'm going to list out those relationships again. I've got FB, that's still the same. BM now, because I've assumed that there's one person in there, B to M is a third cousin, which means S to M is also a third cousin, and F to M is a second cousin once removed. Now we can use some of our knowledge that when it comes to third cousins, we only share DNA with about 90% of them. With second cousins once removed, we only share DNA with 95% of them. So when we look at this, we know that, I'm assuming, S and B share DNA, because I think Cosmic Slice would have told me otherwise. Now, because F is the father of S, F and B also share DNA. She stated clearly that B and M share DNA because that's in the ancestry match list, but S and M do not share DNA, and F and M do not share DNA. Well, you'll notice here that S and M, they are third cousins, which don't share DNA all the time. Most of the time, 90% of the time, they share DNA, but not all of the time. And second cousin once removed, they also only share DNA 95% of the time. And since S is descended from F, if her father does not share DNA, then she couldn't share DNA. So if this is an X, this has to be an X. And it is possible for both of these to be X's. So this is one solution, is that there is one generation between D and M. In other words, D is the grandparent of M. So in this case, because of the DNA that Cosmic Slice has, we can actually do some of these tests, and we know S is a child of F. If F doesn't match, S can't match. So if one generation is possible between them, two generations then is also possible, because that's going to make the relationship even further apart. It's going to change the third cousins to third cousins once removed, and it's going to change the second cousins once removed to third cousins. So let's go the opposite way and assume that there are zero generations between D and M. In other words, you'll notice here, D is the parent of M. I've moved M up to this next generation right here, and we can write out the relationships there. S to B is going to be a third cousin. F to B is still a second cousin once removed. Now, B to M is a second cousin once removed. S to M is a second cousin once removed. And F to M is a second cousin. And we can see that because F and M are in the same line, and this happens to be the second cousin line based on how this is drawn, which means B and S, they are just one generation removed, so second cousins once removed from M. So we can see then that the relationship has changed by just changing that one assumption. Now we know something. All second cousins share DNA, and actually it's 99 plus percent. There's statistically a possibility they don't, but as far as I know, no second cousins that are confirmed second cousins have been found that don't share DNA. Well, when we look at this, as far as who shares DNA, S and B do, F and B do, B and M do, S and M don't, but it's possible that they don't because second cousin once removed might not share DNA. However, we get to F and M, they don't share DNA, but if they were second cousins, they would have to share DNA. And so that is wrong, which means that there must be at least one generation between C and M. So in other words, M has to be either the grandchild or the great-grandchild of C. And that is why S and F are not sharing DNA with M, but B is sharing DNA with M. So I hope that this was helpful in taking you through how to resolve these questions that come up with DNA. I like to draw things out because sometimes in our minds, we're thinking a certain relationship, but once we draw it out, we see that, oh, it's actually this other relationship that it is, and then using some different data with that to help. The other thing that you'll notice I did is I didn't just use one assumption and say, okay, this has got to be it. I used other assumptions as well, changed that one assumption to make sure that it couldn't be something else. And in this case, it can't be that zero generations. It has to be at least one. It could be two or three or four, but you probably aren't going to have three or four generations below that that have tested DNA just because of how long DNA testing has been out. So my guess is it's probably one generation, maybe two generations different between that, as far as the relationship between M and C. So if you like this video about going through a step-by-step process, then you can always watch this other video about a problem that needs to be solved in research. Or if you want to watch something else on DNA, then check out this video down below.